Hello, this video will show the blender shortcuts in Edemo for speeding up our 3D modeling. I will use this default script. I select it, and we can use shortcut tab to switch to Edemo. If we press tab again, we go back to object mode. Now we are entering to the Edemo. I press tab, and then I right click to subdivide this script. I will use this script for demonstrate how we can use the shortcuts in Edemo. To make selection, we can press 1, 2, 3 to make selection for the vertex, edges, and face. For example, I press 1 to select the vertex, press 2 to select the edges, press 3 to select the face. To make multiple selection, we can use shift. For example, I select the vertex, select one vertex, and shift to select the multiple vertex. Same thing for the edge. We can shift to select the edges. For the face, shift to multiple selection for the face. If we want to make loop selection, we can use Alt. I press 2 to switch to select the edge and Alt to click here to make the edge loop. If we Alt and Shift to click here to add the multiple edge loop. Same thing to the vertex and the face. One tricky thing is if we ought to click here, we can select the vertical loop. If we ought click here to select the horizontal loop here. If we want to select all, we can press A to select all the face. And then if we want to deselect all, we can click the empty space, or we can press shortcut Alt A. And then we can use B to make both selection. B selection. And then C, we can click and drag to make selection. And then use Escape or Enter to create this C selection. In Blender, tree is standing for grab. It has same meaning as move. So if we select a vertex, press G, we can move the vertex. Same thing, we can select edge and G to move it. Select a face, G to move it. At the same time, we can use R to rotate and S to scale up it or scale down it. If we change our mind, we can press Ctrl EZ to undo everything. We can see that if we use G to move it, we can move it freely. If we want to move it in one direction, for example, I move it in X direction, I press X to move it along X axis. If we press Y, we can move it in Y direction. And if we press Z, we can move it in Z direction. Same thing, if we want to rotate it, press R. And X, we can rotate along X axis. Press Y, we can rotate it along Y direction. Press Z to rotate along Z direction. Same thing to the S to scale it in X and Y and Z direction. When we're using G, R, S to move it, rotate, and scale it. We can use Shift to lock one direction, for example, I select faces and rotate. We can rotate freely. If we want to lock one direction, for example, lock X direction, we can press Shift X. It locks X direction, so we rotate on the Y Z plane. If we press Shift Y, it locks Y direction, so it rotates on X Z plane. If we press Shift Z, it locks Z direction, so it rotates on XY plane. We can use the same shortcut, Shift and the direction, to lock the direction for moving, rotating, and scaling. E for the extrude is the most frequent used in the at the mode. I delete these faces. And then I select vertex and press E to extrude the vertex. And undo, I can select two vertex and extrude it. Same thing, we can press X to extrude in X direction, Y to extrude in Y direction, and Z to extrude in Z direction. We can also extrude the edges. I select the edges and E to extrude the edges. Same thing, we can select the face. We can press E to extrude the face. And then we can use S to scale and E to extrude, S to scale it, and E to extrude. This is frequently used in demo. We can use E to extrude to form the 3D shape. For 3D modeling, in case we don't have the edge to form the shape, we can use loop cut to add the edges. We can press Ctrl R to add the loop cut here and click. And we can choose the location and click again. We can have a menu to adjust the loop cut. We can increase the cuts here and different shape of the cuts here. If he has something unwanted, we can delete it by using delete key or X key. For example, I select the vertex and press X to delete the vertex, or we can press X to dissolve the vertex. We can delete the vertex but keep the face. Same thing to the edges, I select the edges and X to delete the edges, or we can use X to dissolve the edges. The final shortcut is the most important shortcut because if we save the files time by time, we don't lose the work, so we can speed up our 3D modeling. We can see that that's done next to Blender. That means unsaved. We can use Ctrl S to save the file, or we can use shortcut Shift Ctrl S to save as another version of the file. This is how we can use the Blender shortcuts to make 3D modeling in Atmo. If you have shortcuts that you use the most, feel free to leave us comment. Thanks again for watching this video. Hope this helped. Please subscribe this channel. More video will be shared with you. I'm Martis B. See you in the next video. Bye bye.